you're watching Fashion Sessions with Amazon, and with me is the very gorgeous Lisa Hayden, fresh from the success of Queen. We have Lisa looking radiant and very, very beautiful.
Thank you so much.
Classic sunglass pieces that every girl must have.
I don't think there's a classic sunglass piece that everyone must have, because I think everyone's face shape is different. Like, I suit quite big sunglasses. I actually suit all sunglasses. And about that collection, I don't have it, because the reason I constantly buy new sunglasses is because I lose the old ones. I've probably got two pairs right now. But I love Wayfarers as well. They're an all-time classic. At the moment, I'm also loving, Giorgio Armani have done a collection of quite small lenses in the front, sort of retro looking with metal pieces in the center, which I really love too. And Chanel has also done some really big, with big white rims on them. So those are nice as well. It's a trending thing, and you have to look at your face shape and then decide what you want to wear.
With me is a stylist, Gautam Kalra. Gautam is going to tell us what are the five must-have frames for sunglasses this summer. You know, summer is just around the corner. In fact, in most parts of the country, it's already here. And you know, who better than the Gautam Kalra to tell us what are the frames that people should pick?
I think that basically the classics will always be there. Like, for example, the Wayfarer, the Aviator, I think the John Lennon glasses. I think most of the glasses in the market for men are pretty much in that space. But I think what's interesting is that designers are doing some amazing stuff with it. Like, some of them are making it in neon, which I think is really great for summer. I also think in a country like India, where it's so much sun, I personally hate glasses with a light lens. Like, I always want it to be dark so it covers the sides, and I have some very cool shades. I think recently I did a show for Rajesh Pratap Singh, and he came up with these incredible insect-like giant glasses. Not for everybody's cup of tea, but, you know, I mean, it's interesting. If you're daring, go out and wear it. But I think the classics will always work. Like, the pretty much takes on these three things and different shapes. I also have this very cool brand that I personally off late love, which is from Italy, called Super Retro Future. And they're like gold on the sides and black classic Wayfarers. And I think people are doing great things with the classics and reinventing them. And I think that, you know, that's pretty much it.
So the top five frames, according to you, would be what? Wayfarers?
Wayfarers. The John Lennon glasses are making a big comeback. I think the Aviators and all its avatars. Neon. And maybe metallic, something in gold, complete gold or silver, something interesting. And yeah,
what about the cat eyes?
Oh, well, for women, yes, like I said, Super Retro Future is all about making, giving you the old shapes in really, really amazing ways. And I think that's a brand I should reveal. People should go look at Super Retro Future, and not just the Dior's and the Valentino's and whatever it is. Yeah.
And the one that you're wearing currently is also very, very cool. It's got a pop of neon orange. nice. And
I think they're Marc Jacobs. I bought them last year in Spain. And yeah, they're quite a hit. I actually had somebody offering me $200 at Hilltop at Goa when I was partying last year to buy it off me. And there was no way I was going to sell it, because I think you have to have an eye to pick up unique shades like that. Yeah,
that's true. So, but where do you think people should wear something like that, like something with a neon pop to, other than the beaches, of course, but where to, like a poolside party?
No, anywhere. I mean, I could wear it to an afternoon lunch if you're wearing something really black and boring. You know, you can add a pop of color. Sunglasses are just such an amazing accessory to hide those eyes from partying the next day. You know, it really depends on your personality and your individuality. Like, where do you really want to wear it? Like, I would wear it beach, yes. I would also just wear it to, you know, a Sunday cocktail somewhere. I could even wear it to a meeting, and especially if I'm wearing something very black. If you notice, I wear all, like, one monotonal color, and then I pop it with my phone, my this, my that, little touches of neon. I think it's about your personality, and you need to, if somebody has a confidence to wear neon to a wherever, they should just wear it.
So wearing sunglasses after dusk is not a faux pas anymore, right, Gautam?
To me it is. I think it's stupid. Like, as in, you know, it has to be functional. There's a purpose for sunglasses, and that is really to cut the sun out of the eyes. I mean, I think you're just trying too hard to wear glasses at night or be cool. I think it's just too put on and too cheesy.
But you can have it like propped up on your head.
You kind of reminded me that I had them. The thing is that I've been at Fashion Week since morning and there's no other, I don't have the case for it today. But you don't even forget, like I forget, like it's like it goes up there until somebody reminds me that I have a pair of glasses. I don't even feel it. So that's a good pair of glasses because it's not weighing me down or denting my scalp.
And one thing people should remember while shopping for sunglasses.
It should suit your face.
Great. That's fantastic. Serious sunglass wisdom coming all the way to you from Gautam Kalra. Thank you so much, Thank Gautam. You. And I feel like I can't be wrong in bed with my sunglasses on.